Hi everyone, welcome back to ExcelFort. In this video, I'm going to share with you how I solved an Excel challenge that was posted recently in Excel BI LinkedIn page. I have given the link in the description below. So let's have a look at the challenge. So the challenge is, we have been given a list of matches here. There are 10 matches, team 1, team 2, and the results for each match is given here. The challenge is to list the teams and the number of matches won by them. In case of draw or equal points, it shouldn't be considered. Here they have given the expected answer. So I have the teams over here in this column and the number of wins are there in the second column. For Chelsea, it did not win any of the matches, so we have to show zero for that. Let's go and have a look at the challenge and how we can solve it in Power Query. I'll take you through step by step. I have my data ready in Power BI. So before we solve the problem, let's have a look at some of the challenges we have in solving this problem. The first thing is we have teams in both the columns, column 1 and column 2. There could be a situation where a team plays only one match. In that case, I won't be able to rely on just one column. So I need to get the unique teams from both the columns. Right. I need to build a table which consists of all the teams from both the columns. And then I need to find out for each team what is the number of matches they have won. So the requirement is I still need to show the team that hasn't won any match. For example, if you look at Chelsea, it has played four matches, but they haven't been able to win any, right? The first one is a loss, second and third one are draws. And the fourth one, they've lost. So still I need to show zero for Chelsea, right? This is one challenge. And the other thing is the result column, where the results have been combined into a single column. So we need to split and find out who the winner is. So my approach is to first create an additional column here. In that we will find out who the winner for each row. Then this will be counted over here in the second table to show what is the team and the number of goals or the points they have scored. Let's get started. I'm not going to do this using the GUI. Rather, we will go and do it within the advanced editor. So let me go and get into the advanced editor. First step is to add a column to the existing table to find out the winner for each match. This is where I have my data as JSON, and I'm going to create a new step. This I will call as winners list. Let's add a column to the source table. Let's name it as winners for each record. For each record, we are going to find out the winning team. For this purpose, let's define let and in statement, because I'm going to have multiple variables within this. This makes my coding much readable and easier. The first task is to extract the first team and the second team goals. So first, let's go and create a variable. Let's say team 1 results. In this case, I need to extract the value before the hyphen. For that, I can use text before delimiter. So the field where I have this is called result. So the delimiter is a hyphen. This is going to give me a text, so I need to convert into a number. I also need to extract the second part of this for the 14.2. So if you want to make a copy of the current line, you can simply press Alt, Shift and down arrow. Let's call it team 2 results. So in this case, I'm going to use after delimiter. Now I have extracted the first and the second part of the result. Third one, I'm going to evaluate the winning team. Let's call it winners. So I'm going to check if team one is greater than team two. Then I'm going to pick team one. Else, if team two is greater than team one, then I can pick team two. Else, they both are equal. In this case, let me provide a null here. Now I can return winners. So now instead of returning source, let me return the second step. Now I have got the new column with the winning team, Real Madrid. This one is null because they have got the same points. I don't need the whole table, I just need the last column, right? So to get only one column from this table, I can get back into the advanced editor, and from this table, from the second step, I'm going to only grab the last column, right? The last column here is winners. So this is my second table, second step. From this table, I'm going to extract winners. This will just give me a single list. So here I have all the teams with nulls. The next step is going to be creating a step where I want to get all the teams that have played, unique list of all the teams. Let's go and do that. So I'm going to create another step here. Let's call this all teams. So for this, I just need to combine team one column and team two columns. So from the source, I just need the first column, which is team one, and I can combine using and sign source team two. Let's replace winners list with all teams and check the results. Okay, there's a mistake here. It's not teams, it should be team. Yes, now I'm getting all the teams, but they are repeating because you find the same team playing multiple matches. To get distinct list of this, I can use list distinct. Now I have all five teams here. Now to this list, I need to add another column over here with the number of matches each team has won. But you cannot add a column to a list, so we need to convert this list into a table. So let's get back into the advanced editor. Well, this is my list. We'll use table.fromList, which asks for a list. Then splitter will be null. And the column header has to be a list again, and we'll call it team. So now I have a table. I have converted this list into a table now. Now if you go back to the previous step, where I have a list with the winning teams, so using this team, I need to add a column to this table and find out the count of each team, so that will give me the expected answer. So let's go to the advanced editor now. I'm going to add my last step. This we can call it result. Here I'm going to add a column to the all teams table to count the teams. So let's add add column. Here I'm going to use all teams, and the column name will be number of wins. Now, instead of using each here, let me use the full form of each. Each is actually a syntax sugar for the complete function. So the function is defined in this way, and the parameter that is passed, we can mention anything, use any name. Let me call it T. Basically, this is passing the current record. When it is adding a column, it iterates over the all teams table and each record from here, right? We are in this table. Each record here will be passed through this function, right? And we can access this from anywhere within this particular add column function. What I want to do is now for each of this line, this team over here, I need to count the number of matches they have won, which is in the previous step, winners list. So now in the next line, the first we need to access the winners list. This list we need to filter to match the current team we are iterating. We can use list dot select each value in winners list should be equal to the record that we are passing, the current record. The column name is team, so we are referring to this particular column over here. When I close, it will return a list. There's a spelling error here. Select. Yes. Let's hit enter and see what we get. We should get list on each row, and I need to replace the output with result over here. Hit enter. Now I'm getting a list on each row. Chelsea did not win anything, so there are no records. For Real Madrid has won 3 matches, there are 3. Juventus 1, and so on. So what we need to do is to count this list. We can use another function called list.count to count the elements. So this should give me the number of matches each team has won. Yeah, this is the answer I was expecting. When you add a column, you can also define the column data type. This is the add column step, and the last part will be column type. We can define the column type here, type number. One last thing we need to do is to sort these results in descending order. Let's sort it. There you go. This is the expected results. Thank you very much, and see you in another video.